Hello everyone, welcome to this video lesson. In this video lesson, we are talking about a topic called energy stored in a wire or elastic energy stored in a wire or work done in stretching the wire. It's a topic that comes under mechanical properties of solids. Let us try understanding what's the meaning of this. We know in Young's modulus or in elasticity, we have a term called modulus of elasticity, which is a measure of elastic nature of the material. If you have higher Young's modulus or higher modulus of elasticity, the body is good in protecting its shape. We have one kind of a modulus called something like Young's modulus. We know Young's modulus is defined as ratio of longitudinal stress, which is defined as force acting per unit area, to the longitudinal strain, which is the ratio of change in the length to its original length. Rearranging the terms, delta L. So I can write the value of the delta L, or else assuming like let the total elongation of the wire under the applied force as some x, I can write Young's modulus as external force applied into length of the wire by area into x. Force that we have applied for producing elongation is yax by l, where x is the increase in the length of the wire and L is the length of the wire itself. Well, you have applied some force, so there is a kind of a elongation happening on the wire. I want to calculate what is the work done in all this process. So let us say let force acted for a small time so that let the elongation in the wire is something like dx. So you have applied a force, then there is an elongation, that means the work is done. So I can write the work done as, I will show dw. Why I am calling it dw as, it is the work done in producing a small elongation dx itself. Now, there are so many elongations like this dx as we are applying the force continuously, and there are so many dws also together. So, to get the total work done, we have to calculate each small work done and add. That's called mathematically a phenomena called like integration. So I shall integrate the equation. Integral of dw equal to integral of f dx. Simplifying it further, integral of differentiation of w is nothing but work done. Integral of, I know the value of f, ya elongation x by original length L and dx. We know for a given wire, Young's modulus, area of cross section and length are constants. Integral of x dx. That's the total work done in this process. Now there is a formula in integration. What is that formula? Integral of x power n dx is equal to x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. Now we are having integral of x power 1 dx. So x power 1 plus 1 by 1 plus 1. That's nothing but equal to x square by 2. Taking this into consideration, from this equation I can write work done as yal. Integral of x power 1 dx is nothing but equal to x square by 2. This is what the work done is. This work done is obviously stored within the wire after the work is done, as the work done cannot disappear as per the law of conservation of energy. Thus, this work done is also called something like the energy stored in a wire. Anyway, I can rewrite this work done W as half YA X by L, subdivided that X square as X and X. But you know, YA X by L is nothing but equal to the force itself. That implies I can calculate the work done as half, this all is nothing but equal to the applied force, and X is nothing but the elongation. So work done can be expressed in terms of half applied force on the wire itself. That's what is the formula for the work done. Of course, we can modify the expressions further, something like, suppose if I have to calculate work done or energy per unit volume, I have to write half force into elongation by volume. Half force into elongation. Volume can be written like area of cross section and the length of the wire. Rearranging the terms, we can get work done per unit volume as half force by area is nothing but equal to stress. I'm just distributing the terms. Elongation by original length is nothing but the strain. So we can write further work done per unit strain. So this is another formula, another way of expressing the same thing as work done as per unit volume as half into stress into strain. That implies if I have to calculate the work done, I can just get the volume this side and write it as half into stress into strain into volume. Or I can also write, basing on the definition of Young's modulus, as Young's modulus is stress by strain, stress can be expressed as half y into strain, and there is another strain. That implies work done can also be expressed as half into y into stress by Young's modulus. That implies work done is equal to half stress square by Young's modulus. Like this, in any of the format, I can write the work done and derive an equation for the work done or the energy stored in the wire. This is how I can calculate the equation for the work done. Thank you for watching. Keep coming back for more and more video lessons. Thank you.